Greetings, everyone. Mute the sound there. Started. Cool. All right, so did a little bit of work. Oh, let me turn the rain down. I don't know, man. They keep blocking my audio, and I haven't played anything copyright written. I've been playing copyright free stuff, so I don't know what the deal is with that. It's kind of annoying, but I guess I just won't play music, which kind of sucks because I like to have a little music going. But anyway, so I've done a little bit of work on this offline. I've also created a new render scene, so I do want to export out to it. And show it. Is my mic loud enough? Maybe if I try some of YouTube's free music, maybe it's a problem because it's Spotify. I have no idea. I guess I need to contact them to tell them that I'm not using copywritten audio. Kind of aggravating. Oh, jeez. This and that crash. Exported. Yes, we are exported. So let me check out the new scene, or show you guys the new Marmoset scene. I've changed the background, and I think this one's gonna work out a little better. So yeah. This is it as of now. So basically today I think I'm gonna start combining the arms and everything and working out the final pose and get some environmental work on the environment stuff a little bit, like get some textures happening, maybe get the snow blocked in. I'd like to work on the hair more because the hair is really holding us back at this point, being kind of nebulous in there. But first things first. So let me go ahead and save that. Let me take a look at the previous scene. Which one was it? Raven Girl reference. Okay. This was the previous scene. Oh no, that's not the skin material. Where is the skin material? That's it. There we go. I don't know. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, they're kind of similar, but I think the other one, I'm going to work with the other one. Since I've actually done more work on the materials in this, trying to prep it for the textures and all that. Let me go ahead and see if I'm up. Oh yeah, it's up. No warnings. Good deal. Just want to plug this. Oops. I'm going to go throw this up. Oops. I'm 3D. Groups. Where's my groups? Material here. Okay, we got the vertex color. We don't need subsurface scattering on the buildings. Down the metalless. We can have some specular. Enough of that. Let me jump back into ZBrush here. Turn off the background. And so yeah, I basically want to get the getting the pose closer to finalized. So let me low res visible. So in the last video I created this pose guide with Z spheres. So we're gonna see how that works out. just to kind of give me a better idea of the overall gesture. And again, the pose reference. Is right here. So we gotta a nice S angle going on. It's one of the things I wanted to do with this. Alright, so go ahead and T-pose what's here. I'll probably won't do the head right now, like pose that, but oops. Go ahead and append my guide over. Oh wait, let me clone it first. Clone. There we go. I guess mainly I'll just try to get the torso and arms where they need to be. Let's auto group that. Hey Pramod, am I saying your name right? Welcome to the stream. So I can hide the hair. Oops. Yeah, streaming's a little weird though. It kind of slows you down a lot. I don't know. It's kind of like it's just weird. But it's fun. I mean, I like doing it. Hopefully, my next project. I hope, you know, because this is kind of unfamiliar territory for me doing like an illustrative. Posed kind of illustrative work. For my next one, I would think I'm going to do more of like from a concept and it'll be something I'll get more into what I know about ZBrush, so I could show more ZBrush stuff. Especially some of the new stuff. Like I'm not able to get into everything on this project because there's just, it's just more because it's more figurative. So yeah, what I'm doing right now is I created this Z-sphere rig as like a pose guide, and I'm working these meshes into that pose, and then I'm going to, geez, I didn't think about the head. Because I don't want to pose the head yet. Did kind of want to get. See if I can do this without really posing the head. I guess I could just store a morph target in the main tool on the head, and that way, so I could finish sculpting it. So I'll just go ahead and store a morph target, and then I can go back to it to finish it out. Oops.
lessons. Groups on. Oops, does not want to grab that shoulder piece there. Give me 1 second. I've got to. I will be right back. All right, I am back. Oops, there we go. It's quite not there. Left.
hard to see. See if I can do something with the transparency. There we go. A little color maybe. There we go. It's a little bit easier to see. What is going on? The neck even do what I'm trying to make it do? Oops. What's going on there? Let me blur that a little more. That's probably close enough for now. Hey, what's up, Victor? How's it going, man? So yeah, what I got here is for the pose, I created a pose guide. Because it's a lot easier to get all the gesture and the Z spheres, and then, so I can kind of like target the pose. That should be good. Just got to be kind of tricky. Oh, what the hell? I didn't take the hair with me on that. shoulders more forward. Oh, it's, yeah, we got that going on. That's cool. So let me see here. There's a little twist. I don't know if that's. Oops. All right, what is going on here? Okay, so do I want to? Yes, kind of bring this whole deal up a little. Need to group all this hair. Need to make this hair one group. There we go. Thank you. the hair would flop over there away from the shoulder. Next thing I want to do is bring the neck up a little or back. Too much of this. Oops. Oh, you know what, let me not just the also want to store morph targets for the teeth and everything as well. Oops. Let me go ahead and delete that store. That way I'll have the That way I'll be able to go back to the head and symmetry and finish it out. Store. That's probably the same thing with the hair. Oh, damn. There we go. And that's about the only thing I'm really worried about. All right. So we got that going. Let's pull this hair out some. I think the legs and everything are fine for now. Yeah, this is good for now. Do want to delete this before I transfer this over, and I can go ahead and T-pose. And high res it. See how we're doing here. Throw the color on, and I'm going to export this scene to see how it's looking. See how it's looking in render. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of stuff to fix on the sculpt, especially in the torso. Man, did that get mangled. Ooh. Forehead showing. Move this hair around a little bit. Export this and take a look at it in Marmoset. And then once this exports, I'm gonna take a little 5 minute break and stretch my shoulders out and stuff. Yeah, if y'all have any questions or anything about ZBrush, or you know, I'll do my best to answer or help or whatever. And just feel free to chat it up. Exported? Yes, we are exported. Let's see what happens. Okay. So yeah. Yeah, that's working out all right. I did want the head a little more up, you know, and over, almost like, you know, to kind of, you know, like she's leaning back a little off the railing. So it's kind of like give that feeling like she might fall or something. But, yeah. Let me see how it looks in grayscale. So yeah, for a lot of my work I typically get the look dev, start doing the look dev pretty early on with the high res, you know, where I just work out a basis for the materials and everything, and then when I get my textures baked and everything, I just plug them in, which they still usually require a lot of adjusting after the textures, but I don't know how far I'm gonna go with the textures yet. So, I mean, who knows? I do not know. What did I do there? I didn't want to do nothing with the lighting right now. I'm gonna kind of see how it looks in clay. Turn that roughness down. So yeah, I've got some fog. You can kind of see how it affects the... how it affects the environment. Skylight ain't doing a whole lot other than just providing some ambience in the background, because once I set the lights in the sky, I pull them out into their own folders, and so we have the lamps, then we have the window. It's kind of mimicking the window that would be over here. Where's the visible shape? I have to put visible shape on. Yeah. And I'm using an Omni light for that. So, because, you know, she's out on the terrace and there's a light coming from the room she was in. So that's the story there. And then we got our lanterns. And so I think next, oh, that's the right side one. Saturate those a little. So I think next when I come back, maybe I'll start working on the props a little. Like just getting some, you know, getting some kind of texture on the lamps, or maybe start blocking out the snow or something. Let me go ahead and save that. Thanks. Yeah, there's still a long ways to go, man. I gotta model some ravens and all kind of stuff for this. So basically I'm going, this is the pose. Well, that was the inspiration for the pose. I'm not gonna, you know, I did want her head up a little more, like looking further up and out. But this is kind of like the image that inspired it, the whole thing initially right here. So I want to do the snow and the ravens and all that, you know, and it, maybe a few more little items out here, maybe a wine glass. I don't know if I'll do the wine glass. That's a little like, whatever. She's just stepping out for a cigarette. She's probably at some party or something and everyone's lame. So, and it's snowing, you know, everyone likes to see the snow. At least I do. If it starts to snow, I like to see it. Step outside and see it come down. So yeah, that's the story there. So let me take, I'm gonna take a little break and I'll be back in about five or so. And of course I've got other this is kind of like the mashup image I did. I just did my own little photo bash, image bash. I'm not gonna do the wings, but this is the girl, more or less, you know. Like, you know, I'm not gonna try to do the exact likeness, because I have no idea who this girl is, and you know, I just have this front shot. So, but that's what I'm going for with the face and everything, in the outfit. So, it's just fairly simple. I might do some jewelry or something yet. I don't know. But that's the story thus far. And this is our background props. So, and then of course the hair. The hair is still very, very nebulous. I don't know, maybe I'll just do sculpted hair. I don't know. I did want to do real-time hair, but we'll see. All right, I'm gonna take five. And I'll be back with you guys in a little bit. Thanks for watching.
All right, I am back. I'm back. Can y'all hear my audio? So let me think about a little snow. I think the best way to do this will be just to, let me see how much snow is in the image. Do, 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 do. Was that rain or snow? Oh, that's definitely snow. All right. See, this little stuff makes it kind of seem like it's rainfall, but no, that's snow. That's snow. That's definitely snow. Let me go ahead. Oops, I don't want to do that. I guess the snow just started, so maybe, I don't know. I don't think, it's not going to be like covered. I'm not going to worry about the floor, because you're never going to see that. I guess I didn't think about how cold that concrete would be, but that's kind of funny. Oh well. All right. Let me see, I have extract here on a not quite what I want. Why is that giving me so much? I don't really want the underside of it like that. Let's try that. That's still like, why am I getting all this? Oh, I guess I have it masked. That's good. That should be enough to work with. Clear that. I can just come in here. Don't really need this. Go ahead and close holes because I'll probably dynamesh this.
All right, so maybe I'll try a little noise. Get a noisemaker out. Kind of want it. Because it's just kind of fallen, so it'll be more. I want it to look more like a dusting. See what that does. So play with these curves. I can get some like. There we go, that's probably something like that. Let me see what happens when I apply it. Nope. Let me turn up the strength. Try that. Wait a minute. You know what? And subdivide this. Really didn't want it. There we go. Something like that. Let me come in here and just inflate a little. Use the deformer here. Nope, too much. Try 0.3. Yeah, that's probably good. All right, I ain't gonna worry about the snow on the edges. So I kind of like that, and I'm probably gonna use that on other parts. So I'll just go ahead and save that noise out. And I usually create a resource folder for every project for things like that, for saving like things that I'll reuse throughout the project. It's just a good little way to control what you're doing. All right, so I guess I'll do the same for up here. Get a little snow happening on these lamps. Well, that it would probably melt because they'd be warm from the light, so I don't know. But maybe a little something. Well, the top wouldn't be. The top wouldn't be would be cold enough. In this area, it would definitely probably melt. Maybe around here. Is this okay? So same thing, I'll do a little extraction. No, not that much extraction. Whoa, why did it get thicker? There we go. I'll go ahead and accept that. And clear it. Let me just see how the noise is going to work on this. Nah. I can go ahead and trim it down. I'll dynamesh it. No. We need to delete lower. There we go. And we'll dynamesh it a little. There we go. Yeah, those holes kind of worked out. Alright, so we'll go back to Noisemaker and I'll just trim what I don't need. Just go ahead and open up that noise. And apply. Come down here. Grab my clay tubes and just get that off there. And I don't know if I'll even keep the snow. You know, I might do something in Substance Painter, but who knows?
Who knows at this point? Another thing I want to try is using dynamics to create snowfall. So what I'm going to do is take this cube here. Let me see, let me make a polymesh 3D. I just want to grab the top part. Delete the rest and subdivide this a bunch of times. See what the grid looks like. Oh yeah. That's probably too much. This should be the top. Let me go ahead and flip it. Wait a minute. Go ahead and get it in my scene. Whoa, wrong. I'm gonna actually select the plane. So what do we want to do here? So I want to insert nano mesh all polygons. Oh wait. Let me delete the subdivision levels. Right.
try that size. That should be enough. So I need to geometry convert to geo. Go ahead and delete that. Oops. Put smooth on. I don't know if this is gonna work because it might be too many. We'll try. We will try. Dynamics. I don't need a collision volume. Max simulation points. 1,000. Let's just see what happens. Nope. Let me see. Is there a way to change that? Mesh density is higher than the specified max simulation points. Let's see. See if there's a setting for this. Lightbox draw performance. Please don't tell me I can't do this, because that would be so cool. Won't divide it. I can divide it afterwards, actually. So let me try that. Be cool if I can make him fall at like a different rate. I guess I can't do this. I guess I'd have to select some and then let me see. It'd be pretty cool if I could have. Let's see here. Where's apply to mesh? That's way over the point limit now. It's running, it's just not doing what I wanted it to do. So I guess I could probably use the micro mesh modifiers to like get it to scatter and everything like that. Contract. Self collision. stop. All right. Let me see if I can do something with the brush. Nothing. Let's do auto groups. Something. That might do something. Let me put poly groups on. That's working. Let's try cloth move or pull. Let's see what pull does. Oh yeah, pull's more like a cooler thing. Probably the best thing would have been to use nano mesh and just kind of randomize it. Cloth move is probably the best one for the job. me see in the strokes palette if there was under elasticity. Okay, yeah, they're pretty high. Maximum elasticity cape. Okay, so let me try turning that up. Stop. What? Let me see what allow expand does. Okay, I'm probably gonna crash ZBrush soon. Shrink. See what expand is. Stop. Alright, that's probably good enough. I can just go ahead and get rid of these. Well, it's kind of... make them up a little bit. Really falling around her, but I can fix that. just subdivide this. Get little droplets. So they're more like, I'll probably have to make a couple like unique snowflakes that are really kind of close to the camera. That would be kind of cool. See how this looks. Nope, I don't want that. Why? All right, let me see how this is gonna look. So we got the snow. This. Ooh, I'm getting hungry. I might have to stop for some lunch here. Still exporting. Oh, snap. Open it at Marmoset. There we go. We got the snowfall. All right. So for the snow material, probably just need it's definitely gonna have some scattering. Let me duplicate the base mesh material. And apply that, name it snow. I can go ahead and delete these unused materials. Wait a minute. Okay. Let's see here. Go ahead and apply it to the actual. Rainbow color, what is going on there? That should not be. Probably because of the scattering. Where is that rainbow color coming from? That is not what I want. Why is that? What is going on there? Let's try thin surface. Oh no. No. No, 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 no. What did I do? Okay. Causing this color shift in the snow. Just go to albedo, see what happens. There we go. And let me apply it to this now. On it, and maybe just a teeny bit of transparency. So that's good for now. We have the snowflakes. All right. Oh wait, we gotta get lantern snow. Haas to get the lantern snow. Alright. There we go. Well, I guess it's lava snow. I don't know how I'm going to control that. Oh yeah, because of the subsurface. I got subsurface on it, so if I turn that down, we won't have it. But I'll have to work that out later. It looks kind of cool. Just make snow one and snow two and just turn the subsurface down on the lantern snow. That will do it. There. All right. And this one is skin. All right, and I guess that's background. Yeah, and some of the snow is still kind of patternized, but that'll be like an ongoing process. Like right here in the front is just like weird. So it's just a matter of deleting those. Yeah, this area right through here, as far as the snow, is pretty good. So I'll probably delete a lot of the snow like around it, but that pattern's actually kind of cool. Because sometimes snow does do that, like if there's wind, it'll like patternize. Gonna give her shoes too. She ain't out there barefoot. Maybe she is. I don't know. Maybe I won't give her shoes. Maybe I won't give her a shoes. She is just a poor girl with no shoes. All right. guess the next thing is probably need to work on these pillars. Like, I'm not crazy about the shape. I mean, I definitely want to sculpt some like wear and tear, and you know, like some kind of rock, you know, try give it a stone look for sure. Probably chip up the edges and whatnot. And you're not really gonna see them, at least that much of them. So I don't, you know, I did want to do something more with them. You know, I don't know. I almost feel like they could be square, maybe, but we'll see. Or maybe they just need texture. Well, they definitely need texture, but maybe like that's all they need is some kind of surface treatment. That's that. Let's see. I don't want to mess with those lights. The lighting's still got a ways to go yet, too. Everything's really got a ways to go. Side. Get something started for the dress as well. Do, 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 do. That's clothing. And now we'll turn the roughness down a bit on that. Where's the roughness? Close that out. And I'm going to take a 5-10 minute break here, stretch my arms and whatnot. not my arms or my shoulders. Yeah, because if I don't do that, man, but after, I'll be hurting. I'll be hurting before I go to bed. It's actually gotten better because I've made a lot of changes to like my the ergonomics of my setup here. Just like just adjusting things and just feeling out what takes the strain off that. So anyway, all right, I will be back in a little bit.
know what? I am actually getting pretty tired. So I'm probably going to hang it up here in a few. Oops. Thank you.
Jeez, I just had realized I had my sound muted. Let me go ahead and try this. Stone feel to these. Thank you. SK trim here. With the bottom too much, no one's going to see the bottoms of these. They're not. What was I using before? Oh yeah, it was the plain planner brush. See if this catches anything. Yeah, once you go over, you know, with something like that, that rock noise brush, if you go back through with the planar brush, it'll just, you just kind of, it'll just catch the lower point. It'll catch the subtractive areas or the recessed areas, and you can just kind of put these little nicks. Get like these little nicks in the things. Just kind of like a happy accident kind of thing. Oops. too much about the outside of those. Yeah. sure how much I like this. But well, I'm gonna throw it in. Export this one last time and see how this stuff's holding up. And call it a day. Forgot to include the snow, so I'll just export that on its own. selected it. I'm not sure if I had it selected. Okay, so one last look in Marmoset. Let it update here. Yeah, that looks a little better. Let's see if we can go to the sharpen things up. Should help bring that texture out. Alright, so this is looking alright. Looking alright, hopefully tomorrow. I'll get more on the hair. So it'll just be a matter of, or maybe I'll start something else tomorrow and take a little break from this, who knows. But anyway, That is gonna be it for me for now. And I will catch y'all later. Thanks for watching and hanging out. Peace. Peace out.